Hey, hello Cancerians! Thank you so much for watching this video. Let's see what cards are showing up for you this week and how we can improve your week. So Cancer, Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus signs. The Ten of Pentacles is showing up for you. The Ace of Pentacles in reverse. The Ten of Swords. Five of Cups. Six of Swords. Eight of Swords. Eight of Swords. Strength Tarot card, the Six of Wands, and the Five of Wands. Okay, Cancer, just let's see what's coming up for you guys. What happened in the past? The Six of Swords, you moved away from something. There was something that you see completely in a completely different light right now, and because of that, you're working together with someone. So this could be that someone has been doing something or saying something, or because of this you see them in a completely different light and you're working together with them. This other person, the Eight of Pentacles is showing up for them in reverse, so maybe they have been forgetting about something, about details. They didn't ask something, they didn't finish something, and they have been leaving something open to discussion, maybe. Something, they left it open. But you see them in different light, and so you're going to work together with them. I think there's something that you can get out of it. Maybe this is someone that has an open, is a business owner, or is very successful in some way. And also because of the Six of Wands is showing up, I think you're seeing them in a different light. You see them as successful. I think you have a lot of respect for this person. Maybe previously you didn't, but right now you see them, maybe you even put them on a pedestal. You really feel like, wow, this person, they're really great. Like, what the hell, how they are doing this. So the Six of Wands is clarified by the Eight of Cups and the Page of Swords in reverse. I think you have maybe you look up to them, or you think, how are they doing this? It's incredible. I think you also said this to them, like supporting them very much, like, oh yeah, you really have to do this because you're so good. You're so good with doing this. So I see a lot of enthusiasm going on at Cancer's side. Like, they're doing so great. You're very proud of someone. The Strength Tarot card is even confirming it. Like, you think this person is very courageous, or you have been doing something that's very courageous, and you're the one who's actually who made this success. Maybe you have been helping them creating this success. You're part of this, that they are a success. So I think you are very proud of them, but you can also be very proud of yourself, Cancer. So the Five of Cups is clarified by the Lovers Tarot card in reverse and the Sun Tarot card. The Five of Cups is about sadness, because I think because there's not a complete commitment between people, and the other person is very hopeful, very bright, they make a new start, they're very positive over something. And what I see that the whole tarot reading is influenced by the Ten of Swords. So there's something that you're cutting out completely, like, this is not what we're going to do. I almost got the feeling that you're seeing someone as looking up to them, and there's at the same time you think, maybe this person doesn't like me, because you put them so much on a pedestal, and you see up to them, you're really, you find them so, maybe this is even, I don't know, celebrity, or you see them as a celebrity, or you feel that they are your, I don't know, but you probably feel like, maybe you feel even betrayed, or you feel that you are not good enough for this person. Or maybe you have been working together with someone and you have been helping them so much. You have been helping them so much out, and right now they're not there for you. Maybe you feel like, hey, you know, you're doing great right now, where's my part? Or can I get a little bit of attention right now as well? Because, you know, I have been spending a lot of time in this project, or a lot of time in this relationship, and I need help right now, or I feel like I need to see you more often, for example. So there's something going on here for Cancer that has to do with being cut out or cutting someone out, or feeling betrayed because you have been helping someone a lot and now they're not there for you, or you feel betrayed because you have been expecting a little bit more from them. The overall theme of this tarot reading is the Ten of Pentacles and the Eight of Pentacles in reverse. So this is about starting a family or being abundant. It could also be about your family in general. I think maybe you have been helping a family member, but I think this is, like I said, like a collaboration, so you have been doing something for them, and so they made this happen, this was successful, this was great. And why is the Ten of Swords showing up and the Five of Cups? Maybe you're at the same time, you're very happy for them that they're having their success, but at the same time it comes with a little sadness that maybe someone hasn't been helping you out. For example, if you are a business owner, because that's, that's a little bit like a more distant, that's not like a love relationship, so that's a little bit more like an easier example to give. For example, when you're a business owner and you have been helping someone out and with a service, and you feel again that you have to help them out, they're very successful in what they're doing, maybe you're a coach, maybe you're a life coach, you have been helping them out, you see them so successful, you're so proud of them, but at the same time you think like, oh, I wish I had someone in the past like that helped me out. Something like that. Maybe you have not been helping out. So maybe there's a little bit like a trauma coming up, or there's something going on in your life that you are going back to. Like, oh, I didn't have that. But of course, this is why you are successful probably today, because the Six of Wands shows up. So everybody has a different route of becoming successful. And again, yeah, like I said, I already knew the Six of Cups was showing up. There's something that you relate to the past. The Eight of Swords is clarified by the Six of Cups and the Seven of Wands. So in the middle of the week, you feel a little stuck. Maybe there is maybe there's even someone entering from your past that you. Maybe this ending with this person was a little strange and you don't know how to respond to this person, and this person is entering your life again. There's something related to you and this person. Something, maybe you know both the same person. Okay, in the end of the week I get the Tower for you. You're the only one at the moment, maybe there's some other readings, in some other readings it will show up as well, but you're the first zodiac sign that has the Ace of Swords in upright. So you are the one who has clarity, and not any other zodiac signs do not have this kind of clarity that you're having at the moment. You feel something is unfinished business. Maybe you have been cutting out someone in the past, and actually you feel that this person needs to be in your life and is not the way you saw them before, but they are actually very valuable and you really love them. I see the Ace of Cups also in this reading, so there's a lot of love for them. You feel a lot of love for them. You might get to the conclusion that you really, really love them for who they are. Maybe you didn't realize yourself previously that how much you love this person. There's a lot of love coming up for you for Cancer. So they have been keeping quiet. Maybe this person you're dealing with, they have been keeping quiet. They maybe they helped you secretly, or something that they did secretly to do something positive for you. Something positive. Yeah, the Two of Cups and the Lovers shows up for you, and the Tower and the Ace of Cups, there's a huge explosion of emotions going on for Cancer. Like, it's almost like Cupid is just directing or pointing his arrows to you, and it's your turn this week. Like a huge, like, feelings are opening up. I got that lately for Libra as well and for Scorpio, but this week it's your turn, or maybe you're dealing with a Scorpio or Libra, or maybe it's in your birth chart a lot. Yeah, I got that last week indeed, not this week, but last week for Scorpio and Libra. But this week Cancers are going to completely, like, wow, what is this? Incredible. It's good to be a little careful. I think someone's going to do something for you that you didn't expect, and something that you really like. But in the end of the week, you feel maybe this is a little like a competition. Maybe they're competing with you. They're trying to compete with you, or they're trying to... They're not... in the end of the week, they're not totally agreeing with you with something. And this is... this is something you don't expect from them. You don't expect that they're going to do that, but they're not agreeing with you. And they are going to be a little bit competitive. There's someone, maybe you're also dealing with a father figure, or this is the father of your children. One card falls on the ground, but I think this person thinks about becoming your partner, or this person thinks about becoming the father of your children. Maybe this person even has ideas on starting a family with you. Well, maybe you want to take it more slowly. I think you don't know what this person wants from you. You maybe want something else from this person than they want from you. Maybe you feel very much in love with this person. You're seen as someone very courageous, someone who actually very positive, but maybe you don't see this. Maybe you don't see this way. Maybe you think people look down on you, or people don't see you as someone positive. But actually, you get the recognition here. You are the one who gets recognition. You are getting clarity over something, how someone thinks about you. And they actually think very positive about you. They... maybe because of the silence, you doubt, like, if this connection with someone else is alright, but it is. And it could be that someone is taking a much more rational approach than you might have thought. So I see a lot of feelings on your side, like very emotional feelings, very much like, oh, this is the one for me, this is the person I'm going to be with. And their side, I see very, like, a rational way of thinking, like, yeah, they're the one for me, but more a little bit in a way of maybe they have like a bucket list, like what their ideal person is like. So I think it's not that they do anything bad or they have bad intentions, but I think you're dealing with someone with a different approach to love life, something like that. Maybe this person is a little more traditional. Yeah, traditional person. In the past, like I said, you see someone just in a very different way. So when they're staying silent, this could be bad news, but it doesn't have to. When I think, when I see these cards, I don't think it's bad news. I think it's more that this person really takes note of every detail, that they're doing things right and doing things correctly, not that something is going wrong. So I think it prevents some kind of disaster, and it tries to prevent something by keeping, by staying silent. Yeah, at the end of the week you will see that this person is a little competitive. Maybe they show a little like a different side of themselves. Maybe you feel betrayed by this person because you have been giving all your love to them, and then in return you get some very cold, distant response. I think the situation will lead to even more clarity about this person. If this is positive or not, I don't see this right away, but what I see is that you are, something's very positive for you. There's something that you get recognition with. I think there's a lot of people who like you, and maybe also, for example, if this person is not treating you right, you this will be noticed by others, and you will get the recognition for something. You will get people see that you're in love, people see that you really like this person, that this is really coming from the heart. And I don't know, maybe you're dealing with someone very traditional, and it's more like they're more doing things in a rational way, like they should be doing this because this is accepted by society kind of thing, or they're searching for someone to marry with, or they it could be that this person is really goal-oriented when it comes to relationships. They want something to get out of it, and it's not something negative. It doesn't have to be something negative directly, but you know, a lot of people are not maybe so easily in love, or easily in love is maybe not the right thing to say, but maybe they really need to take time before they can feel something, or before they let someone in. I think this person is more a little distant. They don't let people into their life very easily. And so because of that, they might come off as a bit rational, a bit calculated maybe sometimes. But this is, I think this person wants to check the waters first, because before they're diving into it. Something like that. And that's also what you notice in the end of the week, that there's a little bit of competitive energy between you and this person. Yeah, so I think being careful with this person is the best thing to do, but it's not that they don't want this, what you want. They also, I think you have the same goals in mind with this relationship, but they test the waters. This is more a person that takes a look at a distance from the situation, and after that doing something with it. So the Tower, clarified by the Knight of Pentacles and the Four of Swords, in reference to that, you might feel pretty stressed out about it and the way they behave towards you. But this is, I think, more so to find out who you are. So they are doing it a little in a different way, and you might not like this, but this is a very different person than you are. You wouldn't do this like how they are doing it. But in the end, this is, I think they want to find out something about you first before they are completely committed, or before they are going to be in a relationship with you. It feels a bit strange in it, but I think this person has dealt with a lot of anxieties and things like that. Maybe they have been going through stuff into their life that makes them a little bit more cautious and trying out people, testing people sometimes a bit. I think the Sun, because the Sun Tower card is showing up for them, so maybe it's not even a very long time before they went through a difficult time, and right now there's a new start, bright start coming up, and you are in it. And so this is something very positive, but maybe this person can't even believe it, that it's real. And so they're trying to test you a little bit. that's the feeling I've got from this reading. So it's not something negative, but I think this person can't believe something. And so they try it, to try you out a little bit. But you will find out more about this person and what their intentions are in the end of the week. And it's, I think they expect something in return. They have other expectations than you have. You expect emotional response in return, and love, and you know, those things that seems for you very natural in a love relationship, and they expect also something from you that they find very natural in a relationship. So two people coming together that have very different things they find important in a relationship. So that's what's going on between you, and this is not something like positive or negative or good or bad, but this is like trying to meet each other in the middle. Something like that. So thank you, Cancer, for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button if you like this video, and see you till the next video.